Good evening, Nana here. In this video, we are going to see about the descriptive flux field. Extended flux field for order management. So we are now going to have a look at the extensive flux field now. So let's go there and then have a look at it. So it's a UCF5. I'm working on UCF5 now. And confirmation will come out of it now. So let me log in. So there are three types of EFFs are available as far as order management is concerned. We are going to begin the first one. You go to the order management and then go to the order management. And then let me create an order. So first drop down the business units. And then I'm going to put the computer services and adults. So once when you go there, you go to the actions and then go to the edit additional information. If I click on it, edit additional information. So we have one customer loyalty. If you click on the customer loyalty, whenever they go there, how loyal he is, he has got a good or a none. Fine. There are two values there. And then if you go to the price header, pricing header information, the sales channel is now coming up. Fine. Click on it. So we have a direct sales inside and then outside sales. So we will now add one more to the header now. Fine. Let us say, revenue potential. So let me add the revenue potential over here. Click on it. So let us now open up one more tab region and then let us now add revenue potential as one additional information at the header level. Click on it. Go there. You go to the setup and maintenance now. Go there. You go to the search. So it's manage extensible flux fields. So manage extensible flux field is a task name. Fine, go there. Click on it now. Go there. And then I will now query for the header. So go there and then click on edit. Does already deploy now? I'm going to click on edit. So unlike DFFs will be having a global segment and then context sensitive segments actually. Here we have a category and then we have context actually. So there is a difference. And then it's more powerful than when compared to DFF. EFF is more powerful. It provides you a lot of information on this. So at the header level, we have got only one of them. We have got only one of them. So that is additional header information. So if you can see on the additional information, what happens? They have the customer loyalty as well as the pricing information is now done. So if you click on the customer loyalty, it has got segments actually. Click on it. You know how we look at this. So edit now. Fine. Select it and then click on edit now. We are going to edit it now. I will now have a look at it and go to the actions and then view context. Now, I will now go to the view context now. And the customer loyalty, I will now go to the view context. So it shows you this now. So these are the information now. So it has got loyalty as one of the what's called attribute character one is about the list of values, is GST loyalty status. It's all then the segments actually. So if you go to the segments, and then this is where it is now. If you go to the associated categories, it is associated with the header information now. And then there is a page also. Fine, it will now show you the customer loyalty as the information over there. So we are now having this now. Fine, whether I click on it. So can I have a look at the segments now? Fine, whether I click on it. I will now try to see what happens. Have a look at the segments now, actions, and then select and add view context is there. And then this is only possible. No, fine. Go there, click on it. I will now go to the manage context and then have a look at it. No, fine. Click on the manage context. And then I will now click on search. Now it will now show you both the context over here. No, customer loyalty is there. So if you go to the manage context and then click on edit now. Now it shows you all these things. No, fine. Go there, click on it. So we have additional hidden information over there now. And then afterwards, context sensitive segments is now fine. Go there, click on loyalty status and click on edit now. So we can edit it now. So edit it and then you can see. This is the GSC loyal status there. Fine, click on the view value sets now. Click on the view value sets. It will now show you this thing and then click on the manage values. It will now show you all the three values. Fine, click on search now. It will show you all the three values. So good. And then none is available. Fine. So similarly, we will now create one thing on the revenue potential. Now create one on the revenue potential. So we are in the main area now. We are in the main area of what? Edit extensive. I have gone there and again come out and then I will now do it now. So I will now keep my cursor on this and then click on edit now. And then let me add one more thing. So the category is only additional line information. Fine. It has got only one category. It has not got much of a category, only one category there. So in the additional header information, what happens? I'm going to add a context. So to add a context, what happens? I go to the manage context. Click on plus. I'm going to give a plus one. So I will now say A01 underscore revenue underscore potentiate. So I'm adding it now. Take a copy of it. And then keep your custom the code. The code and the API name gets auto-populated. No need to provide it off. And click on it now. And then the behavior is single row. I don't know what exactly the multiple row basically. The single row. I just make it a copy. So the segments will not be coming. Otherwise, what happens? You give the usages basically. Once on the usages, what happens? The segment will be coming. If I click on plus now, it has got only one usages. You go there. You drop down. You'll be having only thing, one link. So give an additional header information. That's the only thing which is there. And then if you give a save, the segments can be created. Give a save. The segments plus will be coming. So after having given the usages, whatever, you go there and then click on plus now fine and go to add the segments. So I will now say again A01 underscore rev underscore potential. Potential, I go there, take a copy now. And then keep your cursor over there now. Everything is getting copied. Paste it over here now. You're not creating a segment fine. Data type is what? Is a character now. I will now say value set. I'm going to create a value set now. If I click on create value set, let me get a value set for this one. And then here, underscore will not work at all. A01. And then I will now say rev underscore potential. So this underscore should not be given as far as the value set is concerned. I'm going to click on it. I will now give a description. Fine. Go there. Module is order management, actually. Go there and then choose the module. Click on search now. You're going to get the module as order management. Click on search. So order management, click on OK. So we are given this as what? As a independent now. You're going to have a value now as a character. And then here I will now make it as a text now. And then maximum length is 10 characters. So with this, what happens? I give a save, the values will be coming now. The manage values will be coming. Click on save now. So give a save, the manage values will be coming. Click on value. So I will now say revenue potential is what? This customer may be having a very high revenue potential now. Right? Well, that is A01 underscore high. So take a copy of it now and then paste it over here. Now if I click on plus now, and then I will now say it's a A01 underscore medium. Medium. So take a copy of it and then put in this place now. And then click on plus, I will now have a low revenue potential. So that what happens, we will not be giving much of importance as far as shipping is concerned now. Because only when the material is available, we'll know ship it. Otherwise, whatever, he has to wait for it. So we have high, medium, and low as three different revenue potentials. Click on save and close now. Fine. The values of the value set is now created. Give a save and close and then come to the main screen of the value set. So in this place, whatever, the value set gets auto-populated now. That is what is coming. And then here, the default type is what? I will now say constant. And then I will now put A01 as a high, as a default one. I'm putting it. So it's a list of values. Okay, fine. So everything is now coming up over here. Now, fine. Click on save and close, by which what happens? The segment is now completed with the only one segment, single segment. Now, fine. Click on save and close. It is not done. Fine, go there. So we have completed the creation of what? The revenue potential as this thing. Fine, as a context. Now, fine. Click on it. And then here, I will now go to the associated. What happens? You go there. Click on save and close and then come out of it. Save and close and then come out of it. So we come to this area. We come to this. And then I will again edit. Fine, click on edit. So we had to create the page also. Click on it. We had to get a page. Click on it. So we had to, what happens, go on the associated pages. I go there. I will now go to the associated categories. And then I have to associate a category. Fine. It's not coming. So the moment you associate it, it will be coming automatically. Here, there's no addition at all. We had to associate your what? The header line information. What happens is that they go to the associated pages now. Associated pages. And then here, we have to associate a page now. Fine. So the page is also not available here for editing now. Fine. So we'll now come out and then do the editing now. And the main page itself will be there as a context and select it. And then here we have to what happens, associate to a page basically. So click on save and close now. Fine. So context is now done. Fine. Here against this, what happens? We have to add the context. We have to add the context and then what happens? We have to add the pages also. Against this, keep a cursor there. So it will not show you all the context. Fine. Click on it. So your A01, we have to add it now. Fine. Go to the actions and then go to select and add. So let us now add our A01 revenue potential now. So go there. A01. And then you have to click on search now. Select it, then click on apply, and then click on OK. So we are adding it on the main page of the edit extensible flux field. So there's no added. So give a save as and when you keep on adding it, give a save. So now you keep your cursor on the appropriate one and then add the pages now. Create a page now. Click on it. So click on it. And then you go to the pages now and click on it. So now go on and have a page now. So click on plus now and let me get a page. So I will now say display name A01. Indicate, fine, revenue potential. So the customer sales representative is now going to indicate the revenue potential. Revenue potential is what is. So he now he has to indicate the revenue potential of this particular customer. Now find the code now. The code gets copied, pasted over here now, and then I will now give a text also. Instructional text line potential to be entered. Fine. Some text I'm entering. Fine. Go the drop down. I'll now go the usage. Fine. Usage is only one usage. Additional information. Fine. Click on OK. So the page is now getting created. Fine. Go the what else? And then you can now keep that. What happens is that it's a E01 is the one. Fine. The 30th one. The 30th one is the E01. You click on it and then here we are going to add it. Fine. So associated context details we are going to add. Fine. Go to the actions and then go to select and add. The page, whatever you want to add it. So I'll now put A01, the context which I just created, and would add it. The page, what happens is the one. So click on apply and then click on OK. So the context is now getting added to the page actually. And that's it. Fine. We have completed everything. Fine, give a save. And then save and close and then come out of it. Let us go there and then re-query it now. So the creation of our what happens, header level context is now complete. Click on it. So if you keep your cursor there, it will not display everything over there. So if you keep your cursor on this one, if you go there. And then A01, if you click on edit now, it will not show you everything. So it shows you the indication. Fine, go ahead, click on cancel now. So here, if you go to the manage context now, fine, if you edit, it now shows you this. If you go to the manage context and then here you go on then query hours now, I click on display now. So it will not show you this now. A01, fine, select it. And then if you click on edit now, in the manage context, if you edit it, it shows you this. And then here, the associated page is this, and then the associated category is this. It now shows you. So by this, we have completed the creation of what? We have created a segment to the category. The category is additional header information now for this one we have created. And then the segment has got, what happens, your context we have created. And the context has got segments and then value sets. So the hierarchy is like this now. You'll be having a EFF called header information. In the header information, we have got a category called additional header information. And then for which, what happens, we have created what's called a segment. The segment has been created. If you go to the, what's called, segments is not shown over here. The code is not coming. Display name is a page display name. So the category is this, and then the segment name is again A01 revenue potential, for which, what happens, we have created one value set with a high, medium, and low. So it's all completed. Fine, we cancel now. So after having completed this, we had to go and then do the what's called deployment. So we had to deploy it. Fine, give a save and close now. Come out of it, and then the main place. What happens? We had to deploy it. Select it, and then since it's created, fine, click on it. We are going to deploy deployment. So fine, click on deploy flux field. So we'll be deploying the flux field. So once when it is deployed, we have to publish it. So once it is published, it will be coming as such. So deployment progress there. Fine, 3 of 3 is now completed. The OK come. Then what happens? It'll now come out of it. So now it has got completed successfully. If I click on OK now, the tick mark will be coming. Now we will now go there and then we will now run the concurrent. Duplicate, run the concurrent. It's called publish extensible flux field with the concurrent. Go there, then click on tools now. You go to the schedule process. And then I will now have, this is not having any parameters anymore. I'll now show it to you. Schedule new process now. It's a publish. Publish ext percentage and then give it a time. Click on OK. If it is not having any parameters, you can just publish it. Click on they're publishing it. So let the concurrent complete, and then what happens when you go for a new sales orders? What happens? You can now see our A1 revenue potential will be coming on the header itself. Click on that now. And then let us now create a new sales order. Go there. It must be running now. It's running fine. Go there. Click on it. We'll not go on and get a new order. So let us now create. Publishing is going on. Go there. Go to the order management, and then here, what happens? Go to the order management. So click on create order, then drop down, and then I will now choose this US1 business unit, and then here it is a computer. That is the result does. And now we'll now go there, go to the actions, and then go to the edit additional information. So we can even give customer loyalty or otherwise pricing information or hours. If you go on there, click on it, click on it. And then you'll be having what? what happened? Probably I may have to save it. I think probably something has happened. Go there. Let me, what happens? First of all, log out and log in. Sometimes what happens? You need to log out and log in also. Go there. Log out and log in. Sometimes when it is completed, we'll see whether it's completed or not. It's completed. Sign out and sign in. Some things need a sign out and sign in, and then click on confirm and then come out of it. close it. And then click on sign in. You go to the order management and then go to the order management and then have a look at it. So click on create order. We are now creating an order. So drop down. I will choose this ES1 business unit. And then it is a computer, services and rentals. Over there. So give a save now. Give a save so that we'll be able to enter the additional information. Go to the actions. And then here we go to the what's called edit additional information. And then we click on the revenue potential. So it'll be having a display. Indicate the revenue potential to be entered. Fine. This is what we are given as an indication. So by default, high is coming. You can even make a change as what, medium or low, depending upon the customer. Make it as medium and then click on OK. So this completes the header level additional EFF. Now I have configured a line level EFF also. I'll not show it to you. Duplicate. I will configure a line level EFF also. You go to the setup and maintenance. You go to the again search and then move to the manage extensible flux fields. So, so it starts in fulfill now. Fulfill. So click on search. I have configured the fulfillment line information as well as your fulfillment line detail information also, but I'm unable to understand where to put it now. Both things are put. I'll now show you first of all the fulfillment line information. I configured both now. So click on edit now. I will now show you fulfillment line information. Fine, both click on it. I will now keep your cursor on this. Click it, it will now show you every associated context. Now, if I click on it, it will now show you all the associated context. So the city is the one which I have done it now. Fine with that. So city is the one. So these are the three things: networking, pricing, line information, and then A01 city one. City one I have not done it. I will now show you. Click on the manage context and then I will now query my A01 and then show it to you. A01. I'm going to give a search now. I'll show it to you. Now there. I'm going to click on edit now. So this context, I'm going to edit it now. So it has got one segment now. Fine, the segment is this now. Fine, go to click on edit the segment and then I'll show it to you. See the segment. I click on edit. So it is now having one value set of what? A01 city 1. And if you give a view value sets, you can now see if you give a what's called this one. And then click on the manage values, it has got two values. Click on search. It'll be having an A01, Madras 1 and then Bombay 1. So Madras 1 and Bombay 1 are the values. Go to click on calculate and then give a cancel. So I have given this as a default one. Madras one as a default no fine at the line level. So I have configured this now. Fine, A01 city one. I give a cancel. And then the next one also I have configured as a color, but I don't know where to go and then see on the sales order. Somebody please help me out because there what am I stuck actually. So I'll now go to the fulfillment line detail information. Fine, click on it. So click on edit now. And then keep your cursor over there. And then you can now see your color has been, line details has been added now. Fine. So here you cannot see just like that now. Fine. If you go to the pages, it will not show you the pages now. The pages has been added now. Fine. But you go to the manage context on the line detail information now. Additional line information. Fine. Additional line information. Fine. Additional line detail information. Fine. Click on it. And this is what is. I will now go on and edit now. We edit it. This is a segment now. Fine. A01 color one is a segment. And then if you click on edit now. And then you can now see the manage values. Go to the view value sets. No, fine. A01 color one. I click on it now. I given some two values. Fine. Click on manage values. And then have a look at it. Fine. I given red and blue. So red on and then blue one. But I am unable to associate this at any of the places in the sales order. Fine. I don't know where it is. Fine. You please tell me about how to do this. No, fine. The color one has to come up. No, fine. I don't understand that exactly. The city is coming. The city is coming, but the color is not coming as a fulfillment line detail information. So this one we have to identify and then tell me where exactly it is. And somebody please write to me at nana.oraclenana.com if you find it out. Cancel it. So go and then cancel it. So it's all completed now. Both things are completed. So and you can see both are also deployed. So city, this has got a city of what? Madras and Bombay. And then this has got a color of what? Red and blue or something like that. Fine. Everything is deployed. And then it's also done. Now in this place, what happens? You go there and then I will now add the line. So click on the add line. So A01 and I'm going to give a tab now. I've already configured a back-to-back buy now. Click on it, click on OK. Now click on add. If I click on add, the line is getting added. So if you go to the right-hand side and then here, you drop down the line level detail information. If I click on drop down and then I will now give a the EFF now. Fine. Additional edit, additional information is the EFF of the sales order line level. Fine, click on it now. Okay. What happens? You got two things. And one is the price line information, one is the networking provider, and then A013 is the one. Fine. If you click on it, what happens? The vendor gets a default over here. If you want to make a change, you can even make a change to mobile. So I'm making a change and then click on OK. The moment you save it, what happens? You cannot edit this at all. And please choose the city of the customer. Now the color is red and blue. I don't know what to give now. I click on OK now. It's not coming. I will not give a save. I'll give a save. It is not saved now. I don't know. After saving, we can edit it or not. OK, we'll now have a look at it. There's no save now at the line level. We go there and then drop down and then we'll now go to the additional line information now. So edit additional information and go there and have a look at it now. So if you go to space, it's still allowing you to edit, I think, probably. Yeah, it's allowing it. But when you submit it, I think it will not be doing it. I'm going to click on it. So it's not done. So let us now submit the sales order. So click on submit. And line level additional information, the color, I don't know. If you click on the project details, it's coming on. I don't see. I don't think it's a project detail, actually. Project will be for project something. It will not be coming now. I'm going to click on it. Cancel now. So where exactly it is now? I'm going to click on it. So it's not coming. If you go to the shipment level, we don't have any additional information. There's one drop it there, fine. Click on drop down and then see whether we can do it or not. So override order line. Okay, fine. That is a different one altogether. This is not a EFF actually. Fine, well, that is not available. I don't know. So let me submit it now. If you go to the billing information, billing will be all purely billing only. So there is one item level drop down is there, fine. Drop it down and we'll see whether we have anything or not. Override and edit accounting details. Fine. Yes. Accounting details is a different one altogether. So this is the billing, this is where it's coming. And the last area is what? It is for the sales credit check. Fine. Oh, that is what a salesperson in sales credit. Fine. Okay, good. I don't know what exactly. Fine. Click on submit now. Fine. We'll now see inside whether we can see this or not. So we are seeing the header level now, but inside what happens, I'm unable to see. So the order is now getting submitted now for processing. The submission is nothing but a customer confirmation upon which what happens, we are initiating a submission now. Click on OK. Now the do will now start to process. Approval pending. Click on the no approval has been set up over there now. So click on processing. You go there, go to the actions and then you go to the switch to fulfillment view now. And here also the view additional is the header information. Go there. You can now see the header information. So is the indicate revenue potential. The customer loyalty pricing and then there are all the header level DFOps actually. So if you go there, line level DFOps are also visible, but line level detail information is not available. I don't know where exactly it is. Now it's coming here in the if you go to the Sutu view here also, it shows you the header level information now here. The header level information is coming. Fine with that. So here you cannot edit it. You cannot edit it. It's already chosen now. Fine, no edit is option is available now. With that. So here, if you go there in the line level, there is an additional information. Fine, click on it, it will not show you the line level information. Oh, this is not showing anything at all. So under line level. This may be a line level detail information, I'm not sure about it, but why it's not showing, I don't know. Navadir. So click on that now. But if you go to the fulfillment line, if you go to the fulfillment lines, and then go there. And then in the last, we have additional information. If you click on the fulfillment lines, and then go to that information, you have this city over there. The line level additional information is now coming. But line level detail, the color is not coming. Where to go and then see this orders. If you click on this line number now, fine, click on the line number. It shows you a lot of information on the line, fine, general lines. There is an additional information if you click on it. It again shows you the line level information. If you click on the now. You don't have any other additional information. Supply details, nothing is there. Back-to-back details, nothing is there. And then the shipping, there is nothing. The billing, there is nothing. In the item details, we have one item details. This is basically item level attributes, basically. Additional attributes of the user defined attributes of the item, actually. And then the transaction screen. Okay. Tax is okay, fine. You know about it. Got stuck now. Fine. Is somebody please find out where exactly it is not fine. It's not available. And then on this one, on the line, what happens there? We have an actions edit also is available. Fine. Go to the actions in the top. We have edit now. Fine. Click on edit. So here we can very well change the warehouses. We can see the suppliers. And then we can see the shipping method. And then the scheduled ship date, scheduled arrival date. Everything we have seen in our classrooms. No, fine. So all this is there. But there is no information on the EFF actually, on the line level detail information. We have a fulfillment line details over here now. Click on it. And then here in the general area, we have this many are coming now. Here again, additional information is only a line detail. And the color is not coming. City is only coming. Click on that now. That's it. So this way, and then I have checked up almost in every tab region. Fine. Nothing is available there. So somebody find out about where exactly the line level detail information, that is what it is. So if you go to the manage extensible flux fields, and then if you click on the fulfill now. So where to see on the sales order? This one, fulfillment line detail information. Fulfillment line detail information. You have flux field code also. So try to, what happens, I make an R&D and then find out how to see this particular code, where exactly it is available now. So if somebody deployment error message is only showing. And that's it for me. So from here, what happens, you know, seeing a header level EFF and then a line level EFF and then line detail EFF, we are unable to find out. So if you find out, please let me know. So thanks for information. Then you can write to me at nana.oraclenana.com or otherwise you can even call me on the mobile or WhatsApp. It's a India number 98418-67924. So you can very well contact me and then tell me and then teach me about how to do this online. Thanks for the assistance. Bye.